Hi guys, I'm excited to do some Pilates with you tonight. So we're gonna focus on strength and going really slow. So I know a lot of times it's so tempting to go fast. We think we might get a little better burn, but generally if we go slow, especially in Pilates, we'll work those muscles that we're really trying to target. So it's gonna be nice and slow. We're gonna have a ton of fun. So you're gonna need hand weights, either weighted balls if you have them or little hand weights. And you can of course do all of it without any hand weights. So 2 to 4 pounds, I wouldn't go higher than 4. Anyways, let's get started. So before we go, just gonna go over a couple quick Pilates basic principles. So we always wanna stay super stable in our shoulders. So if you raise your shoulders all the way up and then all the way down, all the way up and down, and then just rise up a little. So you never wanna be all the way stuck down so that your shoulders can be stable. So that if you get tired, they have somewhere to go. Okay, so also our breath is super important. It's in through the nose, exhale through the mouth. So you get big inhale, you open the ribs up and out behind you. So inhale, exhale, feel those ribs come in. So the shoulders should move, the chest should move, breathing deep here. So you wanna really get those ribs to move because your abdominals are connected to your ribs. So if you can get those to move, you can get those transverse abdominals to connect, okay? So also our neutral spine. So we'll just come down. So if you bring the pad of your hand and your fingers, make a little diamond here. So what we're going for is if this was on your hips, and I'll show you in just a second, if you had a cup in this diamond right here, it would be straight up and down, okay? So I'll show you. Get that pad of the hand, put it on the hip bone, draw that diamond low. So you want that cup be just right up and down, okay? So no water and spill. And then if we are in imprint, you take a big, you are thinking of closing the distance between your rib and your hip. A lot of times in fitness, you'll hear low back on the mat, but that's not necessarily imprint for everyone. Everyone's spine's a little different. So if you can just pull the ribs to hips, it will, pelvis will tip a little, and maybe your back will go flat. Mine doesn't. And then go back to neutral. So we're just gonna try that because that's just super key in keeping those abdominals engaged. So inhale, exhale, pull the ribs to hips. Feel those abdominals connect. You don't have to do a big crunch to feel those abdominals connect. Inhale, you're in neutral. Exhale, pull the ribs to hips. Inhale, neutral. So just feel the pelvis tuck a little and pull the ribs pulling down. One more like that. Okay, again, we're gonna go over those ribs. So if you are to lift your arms, notice my ribs. If I go all the way back, my ribs kind of open, my back pops. So we're gonna keep those arms in a place where we can keep those ribs engaged, okay? So for me, I can't go further than this without losing my abdominal connection. So just be mindful of that the whole time. So if you, let's go a couple arm circles. Inhale, the ribs will open as you inhale, exhale. They'll close, but they're not gonna pop open. You're not gonna lose that connection. And let's go other direction. Inhale, and up. Inhale, sweep. Exhale, up. Okay, now, last little thing we're gonna be thinking about all throughout class is a little cranial nod. So what you're gonna think is making your neck long. So you kind of have your eye gaze follow the ceiling, kind of to where the corner is. Feel that back of the neck lengthen, and then you'll go back. Nod, and come up. So if you can get that nod every time before you go up into flexion, it'll take a lot of the stress out of the neck, okay? So we'll just start with a little ab prep. Inhale, you'll nod the chin. Exhale, glide ribs to hip, and come up. Inhale, hold, exhale down. So notice the difference between that, feel that neck, or the little nod and then roll up and feel it go right into your abdominals. And down, nod the chin, exhale up. Inhale, hold, exhale down. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Let's go two more of those. Feel those abdominals go nice and flat. Good, now we're just gonna come down. We're gonna warm up our spine. Starting at your tailbone, tuck the tailbone, roll up one vertebrae at a time. Inhale, hold. Exhale, roll down. I'm just gonna walk you through what you're trying to feel here. One vertebrae at a time, peels up. On your exhale. You should feel the quads lengthening. You're not going so high up that your ribs are popping. You're keeping that all in. And down. Let's go two more. Roll up. And roll down. Really feel that nice quad stretch at the top. Slow and controlled. One vertebrae at a time, especially those low vertebrae. Don't let them skip. Take the time to really articulate through this body. Okay, now we're gonna shift into imprint. Remember, pull ribs to hips, lift the legs up. Big inhale, use your abdominals, feel your abdominals lift the other leg up. Good, bring the arms to the side. Inhale, drop to one side. As you exhale, you're not gonna move yet. Start the exhale, pull the belly button in. Feel the obliques engage, so your abdominals, your obliques lift you back up. Inhale, rotate. Exhale, first. Then continue the exhale up. Let's go one more each side. Start that exhale first. Okay, we're gonna add on. So you're gonna, I'm just gonna scoot over so I don't kick my wall. Okay, so you're gonna inhale lower. Exhale, extend the leg. Use your abdominals to lift up. Lower the leg. Inhale lower. Extend the leg. Exhale up. Inhale. Exhale. Okay, let's add on again or stay where you were. Inhale, both legs extend. Really use those obliques. Exhale. So good, you guys. Inhale. One more each side. Lower down. Okay, we're gonna go into a half roll back. So just bring the knees in, roll up. Okay, we're gonna do the first couple without your hand weights. So you're just gonna exhale, roll back. Inhale, hold. Exhale. So I want you to think of the tuck starts with the tailbone. So you're trying to get the low back on the mat first. Okay, you inhale. Exhale, you're not coming out of the contraction, you're going deeper. Pull the belly button to the back of the room. Inhale back. And then exhale. Inhale, hold. Exhale. Last one. Okay, stack up. We're gonna stay with that same move. Grab your hand weights. Okay, roll halfway back. Inhale, hold. Exhale, pull that belly button back. Stay in that C curve. Come back. Roll right back. Exhale. Okay, we're gonna add on here. Hold. Right leg. Or how about arm, right arm, down and up, and come center, left arm, down, up, center, roll forward. One more, just like that. Let's start with the other arm this time, down, up, pull that belly button in, center, down, up, center, exhale. Okay, let's add on. Roll back. lift, ooh, lower, exhale. Now remember, when you're going forward, you're going deeper into that contraction. Lift both arms as far as you can, keep those ribs connected, belly button in, lower, exhale, and back. Okay, let's add a little circle, lift up, circle, forward. So we're going to speed up a tiny bit, lift up, circle, forward, roll, circle, switch that circle, roll back, circle, up, come in front of you, and then go deeper into that contraction, and roll back from the hips first. Okay, let's roll all the way down, one vertebrae at a time. Okay, hands are going to go on your weights or the ball, so you just have a little bit of stability you're working with. You're going to lift and lower into the bridge this time. This time you're not articulating, you're just going to lift up, lower down. So your spine is a piece of plywood, everything lifts. The first thing to come down is the tailbone. Exhale up. Inhale down. Exhale. Inhale. Two more here. Okay, just gonna add on a little coordination. Okay, so arms are gonna lift only to where you can keep those ribs engaged. Exhale, they'll lower as the bum lifts to the sky. Inhale. Exhale. Belly button's in. Pull those ribs in as you lift. Two more. You got it. And I know my fast people are gonna wanna go fast, so I'll let you go fast right here. Go 8, 7, 6. Last one, hold up. Drag the left foot out and pull it in. Other foot out. So your bum's gonna hover, and then you'll pull in, up and high. Lower, lift up, high. Keep those ribs in. Inhale, exhale, two more. Hold here. Lift the right leg, heel, ball, toe, lift up to the sky. Flex the foot, lower and lift for 8. Notice if your hips are level, you'll be able to tell if one bum cheek is hitting before the other. Go 3, 2, 1, hold there. Lower the leg as you point the toe. Lift up, flex. Lower point, exhale up. Two more. Last one. Lower the leg. Go toe, ball, heel, lower down. Lift right back up. We got that other side. Peel the foot off. Heel, ball, toe, keeping the hips level. Flex your foot. Lower and lift. 8. If you need to, just bend that leg. Last one, we're gonna go into those lower and lift. So you lower down with a point, lift up, flex, lower down, point. Now notice if that stabilizing leg is going out to the side and pull it in, you want it tracked in with the hips. Go 3, 2, 1, lower down, toe, ball, heel, roll down one vertebrae at a time. So good, knees to the chest. Okay, so we're gonna go into single leg circles. This is one of my all-time favorite Pilates moves, but one that I feel like is done incorrectly the most. So we're just gonna slow down a little. So bring the leg in, you're in neutral spine here. The leg can be bent. I'm not super flexible in the hamstring because I'm a runner and a biker. So your leg doesn't have to be straight, it's okay. But what does have to happen, these hips are not gonna rock side to side. If they rock, you're taking the work out of the muscles. So you can make your legs slower. And also, we're pausing at the top every single time. We don't wanna use any momentum, okay? So you're gonna inhale, open up outside the body. Exhale, cross and lift. I like to put my hands on my hips. Inhale, exhale. Because you wanna make sure those hips aren't rocking and rolling. Those abs are lifting you back up. Inhale. Exhale, abdominals pull you up. Once you can tell you're keeping those hips still, you can lower the arms. Last one. Other direction. You inhale, you cross the body. Don't let those hips rot. Exhale, lift. You pause, no momentum. Inhale, exhale. Notice what your glutes are doing. Are your bum cheeks clench? Try to relax them so that your abdominals can do all the work. Working all those tiny stabilizing muscles around the hip. You got two more. Knee into the chest, take a little stretch, drop to one side. And come center, pull that knee in, give that hip flexor a little break. And let's go other side. Stabilize the hips first, make sure you're nice and even. Lift the leg up. Inhale, we're gonna open up. Exhale, cross. Pause, no momentum. Put your hands on your hips if you need a little check. If you can stay in that proper spinal alignment, hip and pelvic alignment, you'll get all the benefit of the actual moves. Feel your abdominals compress to lift you up. This is your last one. Other direction. Pause. Relax those glutes if you're starting to grip. You got it, two more. Knee in. So good. Drop to the side. Look in the opposite direction. Come center. Grab those hand weights. And obviously, this one is really challenging, so we're going into the 100. Drop the weights if you need to, but this is a slow 100 because we have those hand weights. So, shift to imprint before you start. Ribs pull the hips. Lift the legs up. We're going to start with them. Staying at tabletop. Cranial vertebral nod. Just nod that chin. Roll up. Inhale. 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale. Exhale. Watch yourself, like look at your abs, make sure they're flattening on the exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Okay, palms face each other. And exhale. And inhale. Exhale. You don't have to add the legs, okay? Okay, both knees in, palms up. Keep pumping. Exhale, if you want, you extend the legs. Inhale. You guys, the whole time, if you need to, if you feel tension in your neck, just lay down. You got it. Last one. Reach a little further. Reach. Lower down. So good. Okay, let's go into some posture work, okay? So we live in the society of this or this. So we're really trying to strengthen that mid upper back so that we can stand nice and tall, okay? So lay down on the belly. None of this work involves the low back. So if you feel the low back at all, first of all, make sure you're breathing. Big inhale and exhale. Second of all, don't lift up so high. It's not a competition of who can be there. That's just in my back. That's no strength involved, okay? So let's have fun with this. Okay, your head's just gonna be hovering. You're gonna take a big inhale, lift, exhale, and inhale. So you're thinking, you guys keep going up and down, you're thinking like those vertebrae by your bra strap or boys like between your shoulder blades, of those coming together, and then they're gonna lengthen as you lay down, and then they'll contract, those vertebrae will come together. Okay, last one like that. Now we're gonna add on. So you inhale, lift. Exhale, lift both arms. Inhale, lower the arms. Exhale, lower the head, nice and slow. We'll speed up in just a minute. Get the feel. Feel those muscles contract in the back and down. Okay, you guys, notice where your glutes are. Are your glutes squeezed to death? Relax them. Let your mid back do the work. Up. And down. Okay, let's lift both the arms and the upper body at once. Lift. And down. Pull that belly button in. As you lift, those abs are helping lift you up. Two more. So good. Okay, shift back. Every time I work that back, they don't get worked a ton. I just like to give it a little counter stretch. Okay, we're gonna go to hamstrings and then we'll go back to that upper back. So you're gonna grab your weight and put it in your ankles, okay? So we're just gonna pulse. So this is a little embarrassing. So if you are doing this at all, up and down with the pelvis there, you're not working your hamstrings and glutes. So there's a tiny tuck, but it just doesn't matter how far you come up. Like right here, my hamstrings and glutes are totally engaged. If I go further, I lift up, I lose all that work. So we're gonna pulse for three. Go three, two, one, extend. Go three, two, one, extend. And again, you don't have to have the hand weight for any of these moves. You should still feel the work. Good job. Pull that belly button in. All right, you guys, we're just gonna add on a tiny bit, okay? We're just gonna lift up, lower down. Lift that whole leg, both legs. How about whole legs, okay? And down. Lift from the glutes. So don't think of lifting ankles first. Think lifting the knees off first, up. And down, last one. Good job. Okay, come on back. Grab your hand weights. Okay, we're gonna go into a little, I can't remember what it's called in yoga, like a bird dog or something. Okay, so you're just gonna lift up one arm and the other. Toes are curled, now you're gonna lift the knees up. Lower the knees. Lift an arm, and the other arm. So notice those ribs aren't gonna open or close, the back isn't gonna arch, everything's staying still. Lift the knees up. And down. Okay, lift, lower. Lift, lower, lift the knees up. Pull the belly button in, lower down. One more time like that, and we're gonna add on. Got it. belly button in. All right, you guys. So, option, stay on those knees, okay? Or, yeah, knees on the mat. Otherwise, you're gonna hover the knees, pull that belly button in, lift one arm, lower down. The other arm. And down. Try not to rock in the hips. Everything stays still. So good. All right, sitting back. Okay, we're gonna go into, we'll work a little more glutes in just a second. We're gonna go into our first push-up series. So stand on up. We're gonna start with the nod of the chin, okay? So you nod that chin. Roll down one vertebrae at a time. We're gonna go four sets. We'll add on as we go. Okay, so my son, if you guys don't know, he looks like Superman, or not Superman, Spider-Man. And so every class I do, I have to do a little Spider-Man because I miss him. So make sure those elbows have a tiny micro bend in them. You're gonna pull a Spider-Man, knee to elbow. Hold, climb up that building and switch. And back, lower down. Two, up two. Nod the chin, pull the belly button in, walk it in. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. You're gonna sink into a squat. Lift up the heels, stand up. Show your balance to the world, lower the heels down. Nod the chin. Roll down one vertebrae at a time. Okay, we're gonna add on two push-ups this time. Knee to elbow, Spider-Man. And switch. You pull it for the whole exhale. Inhale, two push-ups. Down, two, up, two. The slower the push-up, the harder it is. Down, two, up. Two, nod the chin, pull the belly button in, and walk up using those abdominals. Roll up. Sink into that squat. Lift the heels. Come up. Find the balance. Three, two, one. Good job. Lower down. Nod the chin. Roll. Walk out. Okay, we're going to add on again. This is our third set. So you're going to go Spider-Man. And switch. Pull that belly button in. Spider-Man. Switch. One more time each side. Okay, now you got your two push-ups. Down. Two. Up. Two. Make sure your head's not leading in that push-up. Down. Two. Up. Two. Nod the chin. We have one more set. Roll it down. Or up, how about we roll up? Sink into that squat. Lift the heels. Find your balance. Belly button's in. Lower the heels. Nod the chin. Walk it down. Spider-Man, let's go. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, one more time each side. Exhale. Inhale, let's go. Exhale. Inhale, you got two push-ups. Down, two, up, two. Use those abdominals to come back up. Down, two, up, two. Okay, lift one leg. And the other leg. Drop the knees, come out of it. Good job, roll those wrists out if you need it. Okay, we're gonna come into that glute work that I promised you. So, you're going to put your weight in like your knee pit. If you don't want to, you don't need the weight, especially if it's slipping out or anything like that. So what we're really trying to do is keep the hips still so that we're not shifting and taking the weight out of our booty, okay? So we're going to lift and lower. Exhale. Inhale. Best part about Pilates is if you're doing it right, you don't need more than 8 to 10 reps. So it's nice to know you're always almost done with any move. Let's go. Two more. Okay, you're gonna lift it up. You're gonna hold. Pull up, 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 up. Keep going. Go 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, I'm just gonna show you. When you're doing these, make sure you're not leaning at all. That takes the work out of the abs. So when you're lifting, keep this knee parallel to the hip, okay? We're gonna lift to the side. Lift, lower. Let's go. Lift. Notice I'm not lifting high because I don't want to rotate. I want the work to be in that booty. You got it. Keep that spine long. Crown of the head to the front of the room or the side, whichever direction you're facing. Two more. Okay, you're gonna draw a big circle. 8, 7. As you go, 6. Try not to let those hips drop. 5. Tiny micro bend in those elbows. Other direction. 8, 7. Keep that belly button in. Try to keep those hips as still as you can. As you get tired, you're a lotus. I started to swing mine a little too. Let's go, last one. So good. Okay, you guys, we're gonna just come to the side. We're gonna do some standing leg work. You don't need that weight anymore. So, you're gonna be here. You're gonna lift and lower. I want you to medially rotate. So, knees trying to point towards the ground. Got it. Ribs are lifted. Shoulders pulled away from the ear on the hips or the hand. Try to keep these hips stacked. 2 more. Let's go. Oh, it's starting to burn. Let's pulse it up. Pulse. Keep that leg rotated down. Keep that femur pointing towards the ground. Go 3, 2, 1, rotate, so you're in parallel leg circles. 8, 7, trying to keep these hips still as you can. Pull that belly button in. Tiny micro bend in the knee, or elbow. You can have a knee in the bend too. Bend in the knee. Yeah, I said it right. Okay, go 2, last 1. Sometimes when my bum hurts, I can't say my words right. Go 8, 7, 6. Woo-hoo. Lift it, try to get it hip height. Last one. Woo. Sink down, take a little stretchy stretch. And while we're on this side, we're gonna go into a little side plank, okay? So we're gonna start, have that weight just really close by. I'm gonna start with mine. You can choose to add it or drop it at any time. So, arm is out a little front because when you come up, I want shoulder stacked over elbow, stacked over wrist, okay? So if this doesn't feel good to you, remember, just drop the weight. We're gonna lift up, feel that side stretch, and lower down with control. Inhale. Lower slow, feel those lats lower you down. Last one here. Okay, you know we have to add on. So your option is to always just stay there. Otherwise, you're gonna bring the top foot in front and kind of cross your ankles, okay? You're gonna lift up. We're gonna go 4, so go into that rainbow, big stretch. When you come down, you're just gonna hover, that bum hovers, and lift up. Weight in the fingertips. You got it. Last one, I think. Woo! Hold here, hold. We're gonna thread through for 5. Press, look behind you, lift your bum up to the sky. Come back to plank. Exhale. Belly button goes in. bringing out those abdominals, make the obliques do the work. You got it. Okay, that was your last one. We're gonna come down slow. Slow, hover, feel those lats engage. Hover, 3, 2, 1. So good. Okay, we're gonna start all the way over on the other side. So other bum cheek gets the same work, okay? So we're on all fours. That weight's in the knee if you used it the first time. Hips are square, wrists and elbows, shoulders all in a tiny micro bend. In the elbows, lift, lower. So you guys, belly button's in. You're not arching the back, you're just lifting from the bum, okay? Not leaning in that leg. You lean, your abs turn off. 2, 1 more, pulse. Pulse without letting the back arch. Got it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower down, lift to the side. You got it. Don't let those hips drop. Don't come here. You got it, last one. Draw big circles, up and around. Slow and controlled, no momentum. Feel that femur move in the socket, okay? You got it. Last one. Other direction, up. No leaning, check in. Make sure that leg's in line with the hip. You got it. Last one. Woo. Okay, we got those leg lifts this side. All right, so you're lifting up here. Those obliques are engaged, holding you strong. Elbow, shoulder, and wrists all in a line. Lift and lower, up and lower. You guys, you're not letting that leg drop. You're pushing down, push and up, push. You should feel just as much work, if not more on the way down as you do on the up. Hips over hips, shoulder over shoulder. Last one. Gotta lift it right back up and pulse. Ooh, remember that leg's rotated down. I forgot to say that. I hope you remembered. You got it. Ooh, it burns. 3, 2, 1. We got circles. Down, hip height. Down, up. No momentum. Ooh. I might need help lifting that leg by the end of these circles. Ha. Last one, other direction. Whew. Doesn't that feel great? Last one. Oh, come down and stretch. Second side always feels so much worse. Okay. Coming to that side plank. Ready? Let's go. We're almost there, you guys. Up and down. Check in with yourself. If you need to adjust, do. When you come up, wrist, elbow, shoulder, all in a line. Woo! Last one. Okay, we're gonna add on. Crisscross those legs, top legs in front, ankles are connected. I like to have my hand out a little more on this one because we go up so high. Lift up, rainbow. Lift those hips and down. You're gonna hover that bum, hover it. And up. And down. Hover. If you need that little break, just drop down, that's okay. All right. This is our last one. Go all the way into that rainbow. And then come into that side plank, thread through. You got it. Or I should say we. I am sweating buckets. All right, last one. Ooh. Center, we gotta come down. Hover, hover, hover. You got it. Go 3, 2, 1. So good. Okay, guys, we're gonna finish with some abs and then we're all done. I'm gonna take you all the way to the 45 minutes and you can stretch on your own. So just know, take a good stretch after, okay? So have those weights to the side. We're gonna start with my favorite, the rollover. So if you've never done it, watch before you try it. You don't wanna turn your head once you're inverted. So you shift to imprint, ribs to hips. Lift up those legs. Inhale, you extend and lift. Exhale, using your abdominals, roll up one more grade at a time. Tap those toes if you can. Make sure you're on your shoulders. Lift the legs parallel, open and flex. Roll down slow, try to keep those knees close to the body. You're getting a hamstring stretch as you're controlling it with your abdominals. So good. Tailbone hits you, lower the legs, bring them together and point. Inhale, exhale. Tap. Make sure you can nod your chin or swallow so you're on your shoulders, not your neck. Open and flex, roll down. Ooh. I don't know if you can see my legs shaking, but they are. Inhale. Exhale, slow and controlled. Use those abdominals. Press through the hands, make those lats work. Ooh. Okay, you guys, we're gonna go opposite direction. Legs stay open and flexed. Inhale. Exhale, use your abdominals. Roll up. Tap. Lift. Close and point. Roll down one vertebrae at a time. Try to keep those legs as close to the face as you can. Tailbone hits. Open. Flex. Inhale, press through the hands. Use your back muscles to help you. Come together and point. All right, I think that's 3. Let's do one more because it's my favorite. Inhale, exhale. Notice when you're rolling down, if you're rolling right down the middle of that spine. Ooh. Knees to chest. All right, you guys, let's finish strong. Grab those hand weights, okay? So shift to imprint. Lift those legs up. Nod that chin. Roll up. Okay, bicycle or single leg stretch in Pilates. So notice, you guys, try to keep that leg at the 45 degree angle. The further you bring it in, the less your abs have to do and the more your hip flexors. Slow and controlled. Belly button's reaching towards the spine. Good. Center. Roll it down. Okay, you guys. We're going to add on. Option, drop your weight. Option, leave your head down. Okay? So, in imprint, nod that chin. Exhale. Roll up. Lift those arms to the ceiling. 8. One more each side. Knees in, roll down. Okay, we got one more variation of the single leg stretch. So, legs at that 90 degree. I notice mine are pulling in, I'm tired. Okay, so lift up. Okay. Okay, nod the chin, roll up. This time bring those arms back as far as you can, keep those abs connected. Keep breathing, inhale, exhale. Belly buttons to spine, last one, roll it down. Okay, grab one hand weight if you want or none. You're gonna put the weight between the knees, you're gonna squeeze on it, okay? Just every time you engage those lower, or those inner thighs, it engages those lower abdominals. So, nod the chin, roll up, reach, reach, center, roll it down. Only keeping those arms as far as you can, keep the abdominals connected. Roll, reach, reach, center, down. Okay, now we're gonna go. As you come up, you're gonna squeeze that weight, okay? So go right to the oblique. Center, squeeze the ball. And down, okay, go other side to start. Squeeze the ball, not the chin, roll up. Center, down, we got two more. Go to the first side, squeeze the ball before you move. Not the chin, roll up. You got it. And down, last one. Squeeze, nod, up. Center, and down. So good. Double leg stretch. Okay. Oh dear, we're done. We ran out of time. Okay, I love you guys. I miss seeing you, and hopefully we'll see you soon. Have fun, have a nice night.